Chicago. We got to Los Angeles in 1982. We were doing the Billy Idol, first Billy Idol solo album. And of course, we were looking for more songs. And one day, Keith kind of stuck me in the control room of the studio at Westlake Studios. And he said, "You're not coming out until you've got something." So I went, "Okay." So he put me in there with a drum machine, just on a boop, bap kind of setting, you know, because I was going to go for something like a Root White Wedding or dancing myself at the time, dancing myself, so blowing the story. Anyway, fuck it, who cares? Anyway, yeah. So the chorus used to just chug on beat, and you could tell for some of the songs. If you just chug on beat sometimes, you never know what you find. So I was chugging on B. But I was thinking a little bit about my sister at that moment in England was getting married. She was going to walk down the aisle, but pregnant, you know. And I just was thinking about, you know, in the old days, that would have been some serious crime or something. I mean, it's not anymore, but I was just trying to look her way into this song, you know, what could I write about? And I just thought, well, maybe I can, what if I make this song like, you know, for some reason her brother is upset about this, and he's coming back with a sort of revenge, maybe some sort of incest or something crazy. Anyway, I just don't know what I was doing. I was just trying to write a fucking song, you know. But yeah, after a little bit, I did come up with the "Hey little sister, what have you done?" You know, and the spaghetti western thing, I like the Clint Eastwood, like all the Ennio Morricone and everything. So I've sort of thought, well, that's a bit like gunfighting. So, because I like some of those gunfighting Marty Robbins ballads and stuff, you know, Big Iron and things. Anyway, I came out after about 20 minutes. I had all these kind of little pieces. I even had the middle bit, you know. And I kind of came out and went, "Teach," said to Keith, "Teach, I've done my homework." And he went, "Oh, come off it, you can't have done it." "Oh, bollocks," sort of thing. I went, "I think so." So we came in the studio. And he took a look, and he said, "Yeah, I think I think we've got something here. We should just work on this. Let's put this little demo you've got going. You've got these pieces. Let's tighten it up." And then later that night, with this tightened up version, I took it to Steve, and then he thought, "This is great. We've got something really good. We can record the next day." We recorded it the next day, and then that night we went and played it live at this club, the Central. It was on Sunset. It's actually the Viper Room now. But back then, it was this musicians' hangout, and it was just like, there's about five guys into jazz or something, kind of looking at us, going, "What the fuck?" Anyway, there we were doing White Wedding for the first time. It wouldn't be the last. We're going to do it tonight, right now.
Watch your phone, it's a